Everything Old is New Again, America's entertainment pop culture talk show.
It may well possess a rudimentary intelligence.
I'm trying to think, but nothing happens.
Felt a great disturbance in the force.
Hello, I'm Mr. Ray.
Come on, Mark, like a dog for me.
Where's the goodies?
Leave the gun. Take the cannoli.
I bet you wouldn't have done anything like this if Mom and Dad were here.
You filthy criminal.
Excuse me while I whip this out.
Go ahead. Make my day.
Here are your hosts, Douglas Viviani and David Cohen.
John Denver and George Burns in...
Oh, God.
I thought you didn't believe in me.
That's just an expression.
I'm more than that. I want you to spread the word. There I am. I exist.
Well, we certainly exist here on Everything Old is New Again. This is Douglas Viviani with the ever wondrous, maybe, David Cohen.
Wondrous, yes.
How about that? It was a little clip there from Oh God, George Burns, John Denver, 1977. And I play that just to get us in the feel here, because once again, we're visiting with a renowned psychic medium, George Anderson. We've been eavesdropping on some lucky listeners who've been receiving readings and messages from beyond from friends and family. This week, we continue with a series of this, I would call it, fascinating peek into the hereafter.
Sure.
David, maybe you just give us a little catch-up if anybody hasn't acknowledged or understand who George is.
Sure.
Give us a little piece of the pie.
Absolutely. Since suffering a near-fatal illness at the age of six, George Anderson has had a special relationship with souls in the hereafter who depend on his ability to bring peace and comfort to their grieving families. George has conducted more than 35,000 sessions and is the most scientifically tested medium in the world. He's earned the respect and acclaim of those in the scientific, medical, and religious fields, and in 1987, his book, We Don't Die, became the first bestseller by a medium. His books have sold more than 1 million copies worldwide. His work is referenced in more than 60 books and has been filmed for dozens of television programs, including his own primetime network special, Contact, Talking to the Dead. Welcome, George.
Thank you.
Great to have you, George, once again. Thank you for doing this. When I understand, I'll say it again, we feel very privileged to have you doing readings on the air live to our and with our listeners. First time you've been doing this since way back in the late 1970s when I was growing up and heard you on the radio.
Yep.
So it's kind of a deja vu for me, but also an odd thing to come full circle here. Well, this I don't want to count those years, but how many there were. But all these years later, to actually meet you is a privilege and a pleasure to have you on the air. So we have someone now. We're going to say it starts with the letter M in New York City. And M, are you with us?
Yes, I am.
Terrific. Okay, so we're going to begin and eavesdrop on your reading with George as we start right now.
Okay, so let's begin and see who comes to visit. Okay, well, immediately a male presence comes forward. All right, let me begin as they did. Now, of course, assuming it has to be somebody connected with you. A male came forward, so I take you understand, yes?
Okay, yes.
I'm not sure about this, but don't help me. There's talk of a younger male, understood?
Yes.
Okay, because I want to be very careful with this. So this individual who definitely tells me I would feel he passed young by today's standards, yes? And then comes forward as family. I'm sure he means it somehow.
Okay.
At least from over there, certainly does draw very close to you. Understood?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And I don't know what this means, and don't help me, but after he did that, he put a big heart over your head. He did change that heart to a sweetheart. Understood?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
It's the feeling of a love relationship. Understood? He does speak of a tragic passing, yes? Just wants to make sure for some reason, obviously, that he did not suffer at the time of passing. Understood?
Yes.
Because after he stated that, this has nothing to do with religion, what I'm about to say, but St. Joseph appeared in the room here, and he's the patron of a happy death. So that appearance confirms what I was told. In his passing, there's a kind of like a falling feeling. Understood?
Yes.
Now, the passing, he tells me, because he showed me a ballpark, that would symbolize it comes out of left field. Understood?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because I don't get the impression you would have been prepared for it. Also spoke of having had health troubles, but not more so in the emotional sense. Understood?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, because, again, when he said health troubles, you probably thought the same thing I did. I started thinking, okay, you know, what do you mean? Cancer or whatever. And he said, no, more in the emotional sense. He does admit struggling when he was here with many times being sick at heart. Understood? Because even when he passed on, he admits he wasn't in the right frame of mind. Understood?
Yes.
The real cause of his passing was being sick at heart. Understood?
Yes.
He does apologize. He kind of screwed his life up. Understood?
Yes.
But one thing he does express with all sincerity, very thankful to you that you always tried to understand him. Lament you that you never gave up on him. Understood?
Yes, I do.
Because you could have. But before we go any further, just want to make sure that you know over there he is all right and in a happy place. He does admit and did kind of contribute to ending his life, but accidentally. Understood?
Mm-hmm.
That's what he's not using the S word. Accident plays a role. Understood?
Yes.
Yeah, because it most definitely does. You know, definitely the feeling from him. I don't think he was expecting this any more than you were. Because, again, not him, not that he's blaming me, but there was, like, carelessness involved. Understood?
Yes.
Now, he does report, even if it was for a brief moment, you might feel as though you've seen him. Understood?
Yeah.
Like, out of the corner of your eye, I could have sworn he was there.
Hmm.
And he just wants to assure you that it was the real McCoy. It didn't last for an hour. It was brief, but enough to be able to identify. Plus, he has come in dreams. Even if you don't recall, I got to cut him rope on that. It just seems that you have had, before this moment, evidences that he's still near. Understood?
Yes, I do.
Because he does bring up, this is just another one, but at least what's happening now, he can confirm what you have already experienced. Using me as an example, he does admit he kind of did live life in the fast lane. Understood?
Yes.
Because obviously knows I'm kind of traditional conservative Joe here who he would do things that I would probably decline. He'd be adventure-oriented. Understood?
Mm-hmm.
Where, you know, he'd go ziplining. Somebody like me would say, no thanks.
Right.
You know, he shows me the old James Dean movies. You know, he's a rebel without a cause. Even at times brings up, you might have gotten pissed at him, that it's almost like at times he's playing Russian roulette with his life. Understood?
Yes, I do.
To certainly wants to make sure you know he always loved you and still does. Yeah, also was inclined to drink as well. Understood?
Yes.
And that was, much of that was done to kind of pacify his emotional state of being. Understood?
Yes, I do.
Because, again, you know, like people, that's the poor man's medication. Mm. Also, thought I heard the name, it sounded like Jim or Tim. Understood?
Mm-hmm.
But passed on?
Hmm.
If not, again, is somebody here, they have to be significant. Then blow it off.
Okay.
Well, the only thing I will state, though, in case I did misunderstand, your sweetheart does speak of people being there with him that were like friends / acquaintances. Now, I know you can't remember everybody he knew in 5 seconds. So maybe, you know, these people were connected with him and they've passed on. And you know, if they were connected with him at one time and you don't know if they've passed on, you can't confirm it. So I'll just leave it alone. Funny, he really didn't believe in a hereafter, understood?
Yes.
Because he didn't even show me the fence, which would tell me, you know, I was a little on the fence about it. He came right out and said he definitely did not believe in a hereafter. And it's funny, he also kids me he would have thought I was full of you-know-what.
Mm-hmm.
But again, he also comes forward stating he's not here to convert anybody. he's learned it for himself, that there is a place to go to. But you don't want to believe it? Don't believe it. And he's got a point, because until we learn it for ourselves, nobody can put their finger on it for sure, even me. I mean, I feel there is, but there could be another explanation. I'm always open to other possibilities.
And with that, we need to take a break. We'll be back here on Everything Old is New Again with George Anderson, continuing this reading with M from New York City, right here on Everything Old is New Again, psychic medium George, exclusively providing readings here on Everything Old is New Again. We'll be back right after this.
Now, back to America's entertainment pop culture talk show, Everything Old is New Again, with Douglas Viviani and David Cohen.
Grandma, please be so nice. She said you came to the place where they buried her. I asked her a question. She said the answer is every day. What did you ask?
Do I need her?
Welcome back to Everything Old is New Again. That's a scene from The Sixth Sense, sort of a little bit of what we're doing here with the psychic medium George Anderson, exclusively on Everything Old is New Again, providing readings right here on Everything Old is New Again for the first time on the radio in 30 years. He's not met with any of these individuals. These are people who have won the contest that we ran a little earlier in the year. And we're happy to have you listening in on the reading with M from New York City. We'll continue that last part of the reading here, and then we'll do a little debrief thereafter.
As long as you know he's all right and in a happy place, he hopes it'll take the bite off.
Good, thank you.
But no matter what, he does hope also that you will continue to go on with your life. Understood?
Yes.
Again, he seems like a pretty straightforward, tell-it-like-it-is type of guy.
Got it.
Now look what he said to me. So there's your example. So you know he's back to his old self. But at least that you know he's also safe where he is. But believe it or not, does thank you that you do pray for him in your own way. Understood?
Yes, I do.
And you must have lit candles for him. If you've done it in church or whatever, I'm just saying, because he did thank for that, or at least somebody has.
Mm-hmm.
I don't mean to laugh, but even when he gets there, he thinks it's a big, funny dream where people that are telling him he's passed on, he's actually making fun of them to their face, telling them, yeah, you're full of it. But certainly does embrace you with love, certainly has adapted there and is in harmony with himself, and does talk about having made new friends. I would have to say he would be an engaging individual. But certainly, believe it or not, ask that you continue to pray for him until we meet again, but certainly wishes you happiness and joyfulness that you continue to go on with your life until we meet again. So with that, he pulls back, and until we meet again, with that, he signs off, and there we go.
Thank you. Thank
okay, you. M from New York, hopefully you found that somewhat worthwhile.
Thank you, yes.
All right, we'll communicate with you and follow up, and thank you so much for your time. We're here on Everything Old is New Again with George Anderson. You want to get a reading yourself, take a look at his website, georgeanderson.com. Certainly on amazon.com, there's tons of books. We're Not Forgotten, Lessons from the Light, Life Between Heaven and Earth, George Anderson. Well, that's the reading with George Anderson. By the way, you can find out more information on George Anderson on georgeanderson.com. Maybe get a reading for yourself over the telephone or in person if you're here on Long Island. Certainly, George is available by telephone to do this for you as well. Very interesting reading. We're going to debrief now with Michelle and see how we did. We're now going to debrief from that reading from psychic medium George Anderson, who just had a reading with a Michelle from New York City, an avid Everything Old is New Again listener, I'm sure.
Yes.
Michelle, are you still there?
Oh, yes, I am. Hi.
you had one person come through on the reading, and I wonder if that was correct or not. You were saying yes, so it's hard as a listener. We don't know what's going through your mind. We just heard the yes or no's to the question. So if you recall that aspect of it, if you could tell us, was this person that was mentioned someone that you can acknowledge or recognize that was in your life?
I mean, yeah, I did have a significant other in college. Who has since passed away? Yes.
Ooh. Okay.
Interesting. And did he pass away young? I mean, I think if I remember, you know, the reading was a little more of on the young side, right?
Yes, it was definitely young. It was a couple of years after I think he graduated. I had lost touch with him at that point, but I heard through like a mutual friend from school that, you know, he had passed away.
Now, the circumstances were a little bit vague as to what happened there, but how do I say this? Was it unusual for you to hear? In other words, I don't think that anyone could have had that reading. Like, if he said that to me, I don't have someone that was a significant other that passed away, kind of a thing. So it's not that common. Right. Does that make sense? Like, it's odd that it focused right on someone that you knew years ago that passed away. Did that have any impression, make an impression upon you about this process?
I mean, it was odd. I mean, I think he was, he made it sound like two things, which is one is it kind of sounded like he passed away from, you know, hard, like something bad happening in his life, or maybe like not drug addiction, but like necessarily, but something that was like from some bad choices he made. And to be honest, I don't know. I had heard that this person died from an illness, you know, but I don't really know the details.
Right.
So, and he also made it sound like this person in the afterlife was like, wanted to like communicate with me, which it was so long ago. I was thinking like, well, I was trying to piece it together. Like, why would he be trying to, you know, communicate with me after all these years, you know? So even though it was accurate about the fact that this guy passed away, this person passed away, like, I just was like, wow, why would he be trying to contact me?
Well, and evidently, you know, still
a
held
long time ago.
Still held a torch for you. Do you know that after your breakup, did he have any other relationships, or is it possible, you know, you were the last girlfriend he had?
I find that highly doubtful that I was the last girlfriend that he had. I mean, I'm sure I was the best one, but
there you go. We all have that though in our mind. You could have been the first, maybe. I don't know, but there's always someone in your mind that got away, kind of, that you think about. I don't know if that makes sense.
I mean, maybe, but like he was a very, very intelligent person with a lot of friends. So I just, you know, have a feeling, you know, he moved on. He got over me, you know. Right. I know that's hard to believe, but, you know, no, I'm being facetious. But honestly, like, it just seemed odd at the time like that. Because I think when George was talking, I was like, oh, wow, could he be talking about this person? Like, so, you know, I was making sense of it. But certainly, like you said, like, if I didn't know anybody who was very close to me in a romantic relationship that died, I would have probably just been like, can we stop? This makes no sense. So, you know, he was accurate about that.
And
as far as kind of freakish.
Right. As far as coming to you, I mean, how many people have this opportunity to have someone that can communicate to the past, to the people who have passed away, you know, speak with you? I mean, does that make sense? Like, he chose to come forward. You didn't choose him. So it's hard to come to the conclusion as to why. But like you say, the fact that something unusual like this came forward, it's not like he said, oh, well, you have an ancestor, it's a grandmother, and her name is Mary or something, you know, like, this is very specific to this gentleman.
It was very specific, and like, it's like, people, like, you don't know if the person has died, you'll never really know, right? But I mean, people do tend to sometimes try to reach out to you from your past who are still alive, so I guess if you're going to buy into the fact that people still communicate from beyond, you know, it makes a kind of sense, you know,
Does this alter or maybe change your belief in that, you know, people in the afterlife are trying to communicate and are using people like George to do it?
I don't really think, wonder about whether people, you know, try to communicate. I guess it makes me hopeful that there's life after here, and that, like, it makes me want to, like, I would love to do another session with him to see what else comes up, you know?
Right. That's a very good point. There was a very limited amount of time to do this in, and it's very interesting that you have a healthy, I would suggest, skepticism towards this, but with that, bringing that to the table, you, and that's specific to your reading, can't really rule this out, and it has to, as it just sounded to you, ignite a little bit of a curiosity as to what in the heck just happened.
Totally. Yeah, I think it does ignite a curiosity. That's a good way to put it. Like, yeah, it definitely didn't, like, close the door on it. I was like, oh, well, that's weird.
Yeah.
And that's interesting. Yeah, like, it was definitely, I would personally have liked to have been able to say more,
right,
or to ask more, because just going like or yes or yes or yeah, no, that, you know, I guess in a way it's good because you're not leading him on, especially over the phone, but, you know, it makes you so curious, you know.
Exactly. And I think that's what, you know, he's curious too. We've had other shows with him on, and he's even says, he doesn't necessarily understand 100% what's going on. And he's open to all kinds of investigation and thoughts and scientific, evaluation. But I don't think,
yeah, he welcomes it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. To say, what is all this? But
yeah.
I think it's something that's beyond that, you know, at this point. It's just very interesting and very, kind of thought provoking, as we said. It's got to open the door to some other thoughts that you know, possibly there's something going on. And that's great to hear, because we've heard that through the years from the ancient Egyptians till now, that there's life after death, and maybe there's a little bit of proof right here. And Michelle, thank you so much for your time and this debrief of allowing us to peer into your life a little bit of an invasion of privacy, but that's the cost of being on Everything Old Is New Again.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
My pleasure.
Take
David,
care.
Anything else? Good.
No, that's it. Thanks, Michelle.
Thank you,
no.
Michelle.
Bye.
Thanks for your time. And we'll be back right after this with George Anderson for another reading. Feel free to take a look at his website, georgeanderson.com, georgeanderson.com. You'll learn more about what's going on and what you can get some more information, books, resources on this whole topic. And on back, Everything Old Is New Again.
You're listening to Everything Old Is New Again, America's entertainment pop culture talk show with Douglas Viviani and David Cohen.
From the beginning of motion picture history, Hollywood has tried to show you what the afterlife is really like. Finally,
wow,
the first true story of what happens after you die. If you see one movie before you die, see Defending Your Life.
Welcome to Everything Old Is New Again. We're experiencing a little piece of the afterlife here on Everything Old Is New Again. We're with David Cohen. David, how are you doing?
Good, good. Riveted.
There you go. We're listening to or eavesdropping some readings that we've had. We've had an advertisement over the air, we know, in a contest, and our listeners are getting to experience a live reading over the air on Everything Old Is New Again with George Anderson. We have a D, I'm going to say the first initial D from Florida, on the line, and we're going to eavesdrop on her reading. The voice you hear will be George Anderson.
Okay, let's begin and see who comes to visit. All right, let me begin as they did. Now, of course, assuming it has to be somebody connected with you. Female came forward, so I take you understand, yes?
Yes.
Okay. Now, one of the females does come to you in a motherly manner, yes?
Yes.
Okay. A lady comes as mom, understood?
Yes.
Your actual mom?
No.
No, she says yes. She must have served a motherly role to you.
Yes.
Okay, as long as you understand.
Yes.
Definitely somebody who was like a mom.
Yes.
As she states. Okay. Yeah, because she does bring up being with you like when you were much younger. Understood?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, that's when I feel better. There must have been a time where, even if it was sporadic, where she did serve the role as an actual mom. Understood?
Yes.
Well, I mean, I'm sure you already know this, but it's still nice to hear. Obviously, always loved you and still does. And even from the hereafter, she reports being around you in a strong motherly manner, like a guardian angel. Understood? I'm sure I already know that, but it's still nice to hear. Kind of a gap of communication with your mom. I don't understand what she means because it felt.
Oh, maybe not right now,
but oh, you know, years ago, maybe.
Yeah, probably.
Okay. There's also talk of loss of a child, understood?
Yes.
They spoke about the loss of a child, and they did bring up that one was before birth. But then they said there was also a loss of a child, but you know that for a fact. Understood?
Yes.
They're giving me one of each gender, so one, and yet there was the feeling of loss of a daughter. Understood?
Yes.
The one child does seem to be yours, yes?
Well, I went through fertility treatment and.
Oh, okay.
So that's probably what you're talking about.
Okay, so because the one child does seem to be yours, or identifies you as the mom, or would have been the mom, the actual mom, you know, all that again. But the soul claims to be with your mom in the hereafter. And so knowing that, you know, I'm going to say she because it feels more like a girl, you know she's in good hands. Yes, this one lady does come to you as a grandmother, yes?
Yes.
Like one you knew better.
Yes.
Who definitely was a time in your life, she must have been the actual mom.
Yes.
So still is around you very much like as a guardian angel, probably no big surprise, but very much nice to hear. Certainly embraces you with love from over there. And does thank you that you do pray for her in your own way. So I take it you do.
Yes.
She herself pretty spiritual, yes?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because she must have had, without telling me anything, she must have had great devotion when she was here on the earth.
Yes.
Does bring up her husband being with her. So I take it your granddad passed too.
Yes.
You know, so the two of them together. Again, wait, there was all, without explaining, there was also talk of your dad, understood?
Yes, please.
Wait, there's people around you, all of them claiming to be grandparents. So I take it they've all passed.
All my grandparents have passed.
Yeah, but they do state that they're with your dad, understood?
Yes.
Who has passed also, they say.
Yes.
Your dad does feel he could have been closer, understood?
Yes.
Because he does express regret to you that you and he could have known each other better.
Yes.
He does remark that there certainly was a significant time of like an emotional gap of communication. Understood?
Yes.
Again, before when you go any further, just wants to make sure you know he always loved you and still does, even though you might have wondered about that. Because... Yes. There must have been a time where there was a feeling of like an emotional death. Understood?
Yes.
But also, and don't take this the wrong way, your dad admits he wasn't the happiest person here. Understood?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Certainly had mental and emotional struggles. Understood?
Yes.
And also, too, admits he was a very lonely man. Understood?
Yeah.
You know, he would, now from over there, he can say he was honestly a lonely man.
Mm-hmm.
Also, too, not that he's blaming, but didn't have the easiest upbringing.
No.
Because doesn't seem like he came from a Leave It to Beaver home.
No.
I mean, I have to be honest with you. I kind of feel sorry for him. Not now, but when he was here on the earth, almost like he was grown up and yet still was like a kid inside. I feel like I'm talking to a kid who can't find his way home.
Mm-hmm.
Because he does tell me he was traumatized as a youth.
Yeah.
And it kind of stunted his growth where emotionally he might not have gotten past 12. You know, where they kind of remain there, like where they feel safe.
Well, he had a drop out of school, so about that time.
Yeah, so there you go. This just may be a symbol, but I'm sure it has me. I see a lot of farms around me. Understood?
He worked for his grandfather as a plumber.
Oh, okay.
He didn't like it.
Yeah.
He didn't like it.
Because that was the point I was kind of getting at. Like, you know, he wasn't thrilled about that. Where over there, he wants to let you know he's in a happy place and kind of on the vacation he never really got. Because definitely was not really happy as a youth and throughout a great deal of his life.
Mm-hmm.
But is very grateful to you that you did make the effort to get closer to him and to understand him. Understood?
Yeah.
Also, not sure, but don't correct me. I thought I heard the name Ed or Fred. Understood?
No.
You sure? All right, I'll leave it with you. Also, did hear the name George, too, yes?
Yes.
Significant?
Yes.
Okay, like, your people over there would know who this is?
Yes.
But the George that's here, there seems to be expression of health concern around him.
Yes.
Maybe you want to keep it under your hat. It doesn't seem to be getting any better. They just seem to be on the alert over there that he could pass. And
okay.
I don't think you'd be shocked by that.
I'm not shocked by it.
The only time they talk about things like this is basically they're not telling you anything you couldn't figure out very easily for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And that seemed to be the case. There also is talk of loss of a sister, but state she's an aunt. I'd have to assume maybe one of your folks lost a sister or sister-in-law.
George lost his sister.
Oh, okay. Probably mm-hmm. was her that talked about George, being that you're telling me that's his sister.
Mm-hmm.
That passed on, that they're on the alert. But in any case, your dad definitely does embrace you with love, along with your grandparents.
Okay.
And with that, they pull back, and the others mm-hmm. too, and there they go.
Okay, Dee from Florida, thank you so much for your time. Hopefully you found that.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
My pleasure. We'll talk with you soon.
Thank you. Okay, thank you. Bye.
And that's George Anderson providing readings. We're eavesdropping over the readings. If you're interested in some information, feel free to look on everythingoldisnewagain.biz website and even better, georgeanderson.com, amazon.com. You can find tons of books that were written by George, best-selling New York Star author. And there's tons of artwork that George has presented and presided over and is for your viewing and sale on eBay, George
yeah.
Anderson. And so it's all eBay, right?
Yeah. Hopefully I'll have some more pieces up this week.
Great. So look at eBay. Just look under the name George Anderson. You'll find the artwork.
Yeah. And great. It is signed by me. They're all originals.
There we go.
And you never know. I'm 65 now. I could be croaking at any time now. They may be worth something.
It'd be a good
someday.
Investment. All right, we'll be back. And Everything Old Is New Again right after this.
This is Everything Old Is New Again, America's entertainment pop culture talk show with Douglas Viviani and David Cohen.
Tell her she's wearing the shirt that I spilt the margarita on and the earrings I gave her for Christmas.
Molly, Sam says to tell you you're wearing the shirt that he spilled the margarita on and the earrings he gave you for Christmas.
All right, we're back here on Everything Old Is New Again with Dee from Florida. We didn't use your real name. We never introduced you to George. There was never any communication. So that's why we were using those synonyms, if you will, for your name. So how are you, Dee? You're back with us.
I'm doing very well. Thank you.
Great. Okay. We just want to we eavesdropped on your reading, and we kind of just want to debrief a little bit here and see where or what you got out of that so we can kind of, I don't know, judge for ourselves how this is going, if that makes any sense. So the question is, someone like a grandmother seemed to come through with suggesting a motherly role. Did that ring a bell to you? Did that make any sense?
Yes, I was extremely close to my grandmother. I miss her terribly. I spent a lot of time with her. I would wait for her to come around the corner after getting off of work, and I would go home with her. She lived on the beach, spent a lot of summers with her. Yes, that rang a definite bell with me.
Wow. Okay. So interesting. So that being the case, then that really struck a chord with you. And after that, there was a discussion of your dad and some emotional difficulties and struggles he had during life, and that it sounded like it may not have been that close. I don't know. It was hard to really interpret from the outside looking in, but was that any way, shape, or form close to what your relationship was with dad, or would we stay on that?
Yes, absolutely. And when I was younger, it was very, very difficult. And then my parents divorced, and he moved on, and he became a different man, so we became close, and I was with him actually holding his hand when he passed away, so yes.
Wow. So that sort of makes sense that he would come back to you and
yeah. And he said he was sorry. If you remember him saying that.
Yes. Yes.
He was sorry.
And that's so interesting that, you know, these are kind of, maybe you agree with me or not, but if you're looking the outside looking in, these are kind of like, you know, general statements, general ideas. But when you specify it to you in particular about your grandmother and your dad, I mean, that's two people out of two people that characteristically apparently made a lot of sense to you. And you can't just say that to anyone that walked off the street and just kind of say that to someone. If they said that to me, it wouldn't make any sense. I don't have the same situation. Life experience that you did, so it seems to have resonated or came pretty close to your experience.
Well, absolutely, and I definitely thought that both of them would come through, so I was happy that they did. But I do have something to tell you. He did mention somebody by the name of Fred, and he said Fred, and I said I don't know anybody by the name of Fred. But
right.
He said let's go on and pass, and you'll think about who it is. And at the end of the reading, I called my mother, and she goes, I don't know a Fred. So I have a twin sister, and I called her, and she goes, Donna, that's Pop. It's my sister's father-in-law. He just passed 6 months ago.
Oh, my goodness.
And we never called him Fred. We always called him Pop. So I didn't even know, I never knew his first name.
Wow, that kind of gives you chills.
Fred. Yeah, it does. And then this morning when I was checking on my Facebook page, you know how they have the memory section that comes up, you have memories with, and there was his picture. You have a memory with Fred, with Pop.
Holy smokes.
I thought that was really strange.
Yeah, he passed away, you're saying, 6 months ago.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. And he came through, and that's interesting the way George kind of stuck with it, and then he said, all right, he's done that to me too, you know, I'll leave it with you. He did someone in my reading by the name of Mary, it turned out to be my great-grandmother, you know, and I was with my grandmother at the time, and they said they were together and so forth, so it sort of it makes sense on reflection, but it's almost a shame you kick yourself in a way for not saying yes just to hear what they had to say, but just to know that person was there, and he gets that mm-hmm. name exactly right. I mean, again, to me, I'm trying to be, what would you say, skeptical of it in a healthy way. But now three out of three of these things are pretty specific to you and are right on the button. So it kind of is it really, to me, lends some level of, gee, you got to really think twice about this and open your mind, in my mind, you know, that I don't know if that's something that you experience.
My mind is always open to that. I've always been interested in this. But I have one more for you. So at the end, he mentioned George.
Right.
And George is my stepdad, and he's been ailing, and he looks ill, and both my mother and I are very worried about him. Mm. So when he said that St. Anthony is standing around him in black, and he won't be, you know, around for long.
Right.
That was something that also was very true.
So, and he's got the name of this person, too. That's...
He was right on with the names.
That's amazing. Definitely. Two out of two names, and then thereafter, two out of two individuals that were described as grandmother and dad. He didn't give us the names, but gave us the circumstances of these people as they lived. So that's pretty amazing. You say you were open to it going in. As you come out of this experience, can you make or did you make in your mind any kind of either affirmation or confirmation or even separate conclusion about what you think went on here?
I just think that he has the ability to talk to people who've passed.
Isn't that?
And some reason he can do that.
Yeah, isn't that amazing?
I don't know. Not everybody can do it. And he was definitely right on, and he has the ability. Yeah. I was very, extremely impressed.
And that's over the telephone, not knowing you in just in 15 minutes. You know, he usually does readings for an hour, and he does them in person and on the phone. But just to get that, and again, I'm not trying to promote him and push him or whatever, but as I've been exposed to him and hearing this and reading his books just these readings this week, and it's just amazing to hear that kind of a connection. To, again, if you're listening from the outside looking in, not talking to you afterwards, and by the way, thank you for taking the time and opening your life up to us like this. It's amazing to, you know, now you hear the debrief here, you and I talking about it, that really makes it come alive. Because if you're just listening to that as an outsider, we don't know, of course, your life story. And now when you affirm to us these four things, two names and two other individuals with specifics, and that's almost, right. I guess we'd say 100%, because we didn't think it was 100%, but Fred then makes sense to you. So there you go, at 100, almost, I mean, I guess we'd say 100% of what he had said. Really.
Well, I think he definitely had a message, and, you know, it kind of gives people hope.
Exactly. To me, it's like, you know, I mean, you're going to have faith on, right? Like, you're going to have faith or not, kind of in your soul anyway. But to me, this puts like a little icing on the cake, saying, okay, or an affirmation. All right, you know, I'm still going forward with this, and I'm glad that we were able to do this with you. And I, again, thank you for your time. And
oh, you're welcome.
And really,
thank you for having me as a guest. I appreciate it.
It's my pleasure. Thank you again, and we'll speak again on it, and certainly tune us in on Everything Old is New Again.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. All right, well, there we have it. Two extraordinary readings here on Everything Old is New Again with George Anderson, who's done, wow, over like 35,000 sessions in the past, and he's the gold standard, if you will, for a medium. He's just incredible. Thank you, George, for spending time with us. This is the second week that George Anderson spent some time with us doing readings on the air. He never met these people, just they called in today and received these readings. You heard what happened. So tune into Everything Old is New Again in the future. We're going to have George back at least two more times to continue these readings. Certainly America's Entertainment Pop Culture Talk Show will continue with that aspect of life as well, talking pop culture next week. But listen, if you're looking for some information more about this, go to georgeanderson.com. That's georgeanderson.com. Certainly, you go to our website, everythingoldisnewagain.biz, everythingoldisnewagain.biz, and we've got the old shows listed there as well. Take a look at some of his books. We Don't Die was the first one from 1990, and they're all on Amazon.com. They've got great Lessons from the Light, Walking in the Garden of Souls, We're Not Forgotten, Our Children Forever. This is a number of them where some readings are done, some explanations are done. It just gives a little bit more background to what's happening here, and I think you'd really enjoy your perspective from these books. Certainly go to the website, everythingoldisnewagain.biz, for any other information you'd like to have about our show. And write to us, oldnewagain@aol.com, oldnewagain@aol.com. Suggest a show, make a comment, question. We enjoy hearing from you. So, George Anderson, thank you very much for your time. We will see you again back here for more of this fascinating topic and hear some readings. And George Anderson can be found on georgeanderson.com. We'll be back next week on Everything Old is New Again.